fast. Then they say, we're going to eat chicken and jollof rice. And they, Christmas Day. Then they put the jollof rice there. And we children, our mouth will be watering like this. Anytime, anything, mommy said, go and do this, we call, hurry up, and we go because of jollof rice. And then we had the jollof rice. It was wonderful. And then I went to secondary school. And then they said jollof rice or white rice. Then I passed out, eating jollof rice, jollof rice, jollof rice. Now, after eating jollof rice many, many years, if they put it on the table now, and they put a gari, eba, what do you call it? When they put eba here, and they put jollof, they say, what will you take? I say, it's a long time I eat eba, give me eba. They say, eba, jollof, I said, jollof rice, I'm fed up. Anything you are taking every time, it will lose its value. It's because you have just started, that's why you think there's something in that thing. There is nothing there. And the man didn't need to understand. That's how he wasted everything that is God. Have we not wasted our beauty? Have we not thrown away our wisdom? The energy, the ability we had originally, the strength of character. Have we not lost everything? And then we're told in verse 14, and when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land. And he began to be in want. And when he went and joined himself unto a citizen of that country. How about the jolly good friends? When there was money and they wanted to waste his money with him. Where are they now? They are nowhere to be found. You see, when you have the money and you are willing to spend, and when you have the energy and you are willing to go to nightclub and you are willing to dance, oh, you'll have many, many people around you. When you are willing, when you are ready to go to bed with a man, they will be running around you. But you are going to have HIV AIDS. You are going to have gonorrhea. And when you begin to have infection, then the men who thought you were beautiful before, they say, the woman has disease now, they will abandon you. If you not go to and knock at their door, they will tell her, I'm not around. I don't want to catch disease. After they have given you disease, then they abandon you and dump you and throw you away, then you become useless. If you have money, while you have the money, they're running around you. I am your friend. I am your uncle. I'm your relative now. Don't you know me? We are together. I will die with you. I will die for you. The money is going to finish. There is nothing that you have, if you misuse, that will not finish. And when everything finishes, all those friends, then you will know whether they are friends or not, they will abandon you. Then you just put your finger in your mouth and I know. I would have been wiser. That's why the Lord is calling you today. That things are bad, but we can still repair it. You are down, but God can still lift you up. You are in famine. The Lord can still bring you into feasting. You have wrecked yourself. You have ruined yourself. You have become poor because of your lifestyle. But the Lord can take you on the journey today and bring you from poverty unto prosperity. We are told that he began to be in want. And then he said, what will I do? And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country. And he sent him into his fields to feed swine. He came to the very least. Now when it says he went to feed the swine, I don't want you to be thinking about, you know, going to a factory or going to this big farm, mechanized farm, where they have all these pigs and they're very neat. Because this, in the olden days, the place was smelly. It was a place he would never have been. And then he was there, feeding them. In fact, you know what the Bible says in verse 16. He would fain to have filled his belly with the husks that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. He even wanted to eat what the swine, what the pigs were eating. It was that bad. And you are telling me, can a condition be like that for a man? Young man, look up here. Your parents gave birth to you in deeper life. And you know the Bible. And you know the wonderful songs. Jesus only is our message. And Jesus only will we see. And your parents dressed you up. And we went to church every Sunday. Now you went to college. As you've gone to college, I want to be free. Bible, Bible every time. Jesus, salvation every time. Holiness, sanctification every time. I want to be free. And then you became free. And then you mix with the boys and the girls. And then you say, isn't this wonderful? This is what Daddy is talking about. Receive Jesus. Have Jesus in your life. You must be born again. If you are not born again, you will never be happy. Daddy doesn't understand. Mommy doesn't understand. Am I not happy now? And then you are mixing with them. And then they begin to tell you to try this and try this and try that. And eventually they introduce you to cult. And they say, if you join it, great time, wonderful time. You'll be powerful. Anybody that you want to hurt, you want to put them under, just say, I tell you, you have authority. And then you begin to consider, I think I will join. And then you join. You thought to join is just to go to their meeting. And then they brought you out. They went to a particular secluded place. And then they began to ill-treat you. They began to torment you. You say, what he says? Didn't you say you wanted to join? In joining is not just taking a chair and sitting down with us. After they tormented you very well, and you almost died, then they cut your body, and they bring out blood, and they bring another blood, mix everything together, they put it in your hand, drink, and then you are shaking like this, and they say, look at this one. You think it's for fun that you join cult? You don't know that you have a price to pay? Then you begin to think, what Daddy told me, if I remain with what Daddy told me, I will not be in this kind of a torment here. What should I do? Should I run? And then the people are, it's like they're almost reading your mind. You cannot go back home. You have come. And you are here. If you run, look at that man there. He will shoot you down. Nobody will know what happened to you here. Then you say, I'm in trouble. Is this what they call cult? I am inside this thing already. And then after they have initiated you, you come out now, you have not seen anything. Then you sleep at night. And then Satan himself, he comes to say, Now that you came to my camp, I'll show you something. And here you are tonight. I thank God you are here. God will deliver you. God will set you free. But you know, people think they're looking for liberty. Let me be free and do what I want to do. That's what this man thought. And then he went now to the place of the swine. You have messed up your life. You've lost your beauty. You've lost your conscience. You've lost your innocence. You have lost your original purity. And now you are living a miserable life. During the day, you are miserable. In the night, you are miserable. You cannot even concentrate now. And you cannot have a straight thought of saying, this way I'm going to live. That's why the Lord brought you here tonight. The Lord wants to deliver you. The Lord wants to set you free. Yes, I understand. The sickness that has now come to your body. Think about a teenager. A teenager already having diabetes. Think about a young person. A young person, he has diabetes, he has tuberculosis, he has asthma, he has ulcer. Young man. How long is he going to live? That's why the Lord brought you here tonight. All those calamities of your life, the Lord will drive them away in Jesus' name. Let's come back to this man. We're looking at the man because it's a picture of everyone there. Everyone that needs deliverance from the Lord. Everyone that wants to come out of misery and come into merriment. Everyone that wants to come out of the state of hopelessness in their lives and comes to a state of happiness in life. And then we are told, and when he came to himself. Why did he come to himself? You see, sometimes disappointments in life makes us to come to ourselves. My friends that were telling me they will die with me, where are they? My friends that were we love you more than your mother, we love you more than your father, we love you more than church, we love you more than God, where are they? My friends are taught, do it. If any trouble comes out, we are behind you. Where are they? He came to himself. Disappointment makes us to come to ourselves. And then we now see, they deceived me. They deceived me. I deceived myself. Life, society has deceived me. What am I going to do now? And he said, how many of my hired servants, of the hired servants of my fathers, have bread enough to eat and to spare, and I perish with hunger? He knew that he was dying. You see, there is a process in death. Every sickness that comes to the body of a man is an agent of death. When there is no feeling in any part of your body, it's saying, now I've affected about 10% of your body. I killed 10%. Next month, I'll take 5%. And next month, the following month, I'll take 5%. I'm killing you little by little. And the man said, I'm dying. I perish with hunger. You know where you are if you are far away from Christ? If you are in the far country away from Christ, you are dying little by little. The cells in your body, they are dying. Your brain is dying. Your mind is getting weakened and dying. Your strength, your energy is going away. You are dying. Your mind is becoming so hardened and so still and so unthinking. You are dying. But the Lord is going to wake you up tonight. I said the Lord will wake you up tonight. Everything that has died in your mind, in your brain, in your body, in your spirit, the Lord will give life tonight in Jesus' name. You know, every drink you drink, you are dying. Every cigarette you smoke, you are dying. In fact, if you go and ask scientists now, they'll tell you what I'm telling you. Because now we're no more ignorant in science. So this man said, I will arise and go to my father. You know, it takes courage. Well, you said bye-bye to say, I come again. And especially young people. Especially young people. Well, you say, I will not listen anymore. I will not be saved. Let what will happen, happen. I have made up my mind. This is how I am going to live. If heaven is going to fall, it will not fall on only one person. Let it fall. And there you are suffering. And you remember that just by the mention of the name of Jesus, all the people are delivered. And then it's coming to your mind. While you are hearing me now, I think I should go back to Christ. I think.